In this video, let us see a clustering problem using single linkage hierarchical clustering method. Assume that the database D is given by the table below. Follow single linkage technique to find clusters in D. Use Euclidean distance measure. Here is a scatter plot of the points on the 2D plane. First, we need to compute the distance matrix. The Euclidean distance between point P1 and P2 is given by square root of x1 minus x2 the whole square plus y1 minus y2 the whole square. Hence, the Euclidean distance between the point P1, 0.40, 0.53 and point P2, 0.22, 0.38 is equal to square root of 0.40 minus 0.22 the whole square plus 0.53 minus 0.38 the whole square is equal to 0.24. So hence the Euclidean distance between the points P1 and P2 on the 2D plane is 0.24. Similarly, compute the Euclidean distance between all the pair of points. Initially, all points are in separate clusters. At each step, we merge the closest pair of clusters until all the clusters are placed under a single cluster. From the distance matrix, identify the shortest distance. So it is 0.10. Hence, the closest pair is P3 and P6. Merge them together. So now P3 and P6 can be merged into one cluster. This is the corresponding dendrogram. Since we have merged together P3 and P6 into a cluster, we no longer require separate entry for P3 and P6. Instead, we can write it as a single entry in the distance matrix. Therefore, we need to recompute the distance from each point to our new cluster P3, P6. So we are using the single linkage method. Hence, the distance between two clusters is the minimum of the distance between any two points in the two clusters. So let us first compute the distance between P3, P6 and P1. The distance between P3, P6 and P1 is the minimum of the distance between P3, P1 and the distance between P6, P1. The distance between P3, P1 is 0.22 and the distance between P1 and P6 is 0.24. The minimum of this is 0.22. Hence, the distance between P1 and P3, P6 using single linkage method is 0.22. Now, the distance between P3, P6 and P2. This is the minimum of the distance between P3, P2 and the distance between P6, P2. The distance between P3, P2 is 0.15 and the distance between P6, P2 is 0.25. The minimum out of this is 0.15. Hence, the distance between P3, P6 and P2 is 0.15. Similarly, compute the distance between P3, P6 and P4. It is 0.16. The distance between P3, P6 and P5 is 0.28. And P3, P6 to P3, P6 is 0. So here is our new distance matrix. Again, identify the smallest distance. It is 0.13. Hence, the closest pair is P2, P5. So we can merge them together into one cluster. So this is the corresponding dendrogram. Again, recompute the distance matrix. Now, P2, P5 can be clubbed together as a single entry. So, compute the distance between P2, P5 and P1. So, it is 0.24. Distance between P2, P5 and P4 is 0.20. Distance between P2, P5 and P3, P6 is 0.15. And the last entry is 0. So, this is the updated distance matrix. Again, identify the smallest distance. It is 0.15. So this is the distance between P3, P6 and P2, P5. Hence, we can club these two clusters together. So now all this form in a one cluster. So this is the corresponding dendrogram. Again, recompute the distance matrix. The distance from P2, P5, P3, P6 to P1 is 0.22. Distance from P2, P5, P3, P6 to P4 is 0.16. And the last entry is 0. Again, identify the smallest value. It is 0.16. This is the distance between P2, P5, P3, P6 and P4. So they can be clubbed together into one cluster. So here is the corresponding dendrogram. Recompute the distance matrix. So P2, P5, P3, P6, P4 forms a single cluster, and the distance to P1 is 0.22. The smallest among these values is 0.22. Finally, we have got only two clusters left. So we can merge together as a single cluster. And this is the corresponding dendrogram. Since all the data points are merged into a single cluster, we can stop the process. And this is our final dendrogram.